the latest now on the state's flu scare. Health officials are working to prevent a possible outbreak of the H1N1 virus. It became a global pandemic earlier this year. And today, the government approved the new swine flu vaccine. It will become available on October 15th. According to the Centers for Disease Control, thousands of people have died from the virus after it quickly spread around the world. Symptoms include fever, sore throat, coughing, headaches, and muscle or joint pain. Here in Rhode Island, officials are getting communities ready for what could be a massive outbreak of the H1N1 virus. Today in Warwick, a seminar got underway to train medical staff on how to take care of people with special needs. Eyewitness News reporter Nathan Nwosu was there and joins us live with the details.
Well, Aaron, the training lasts 3 days, and each session begins with flu shots for everyone who attends. Now, the hope is that not only they will be healthy, but they'll encourage others to get the seasonal and H1N1 flu vaccines, particularly those with underlying conditions.
It's so important to be prepared.
These are the people who work closely with the disabled and others with special needs. They came to the Radisson Airport Hotel in Warwick to learn more about the H1N1 flu.
Our biggest concern especially are those individuals who typically get hit harder during the seasonal flu shot, who tend to have a more challenging time. Those could be individuals with respiratory problems, with underlying medical conditions.
H1N1 is most severe in those with underlying conditions. Community leaders were encouraged to take what they learned here back to their groups, family, and friends. The health department also suggests that all Rhode Islanders create an emergency kit full of important numbers and medications. Those with special needs are encouraged to sign up for the state's Special Needs Emergency Registry.
An opportunity for Rhode Islanders to identify themselves and identify certain medical conditions so that we can ensure that they receive information regarding the vaccine and H1N1.
Now, information on how to sign up for the Special Needs Registry can be found on our website, WPRI.com. Now, as we mentioned, the government approved the H1N1 vaccine. Children and pregnant women will get it first, followed by those with underlying conditions. Nneka Nwosu, Eyewitness News.
Eyewitness.